what you mean to me. Here in my heart, I believe your love is all I'll ever need. Holding you close through the night, I need.
Thank you. Clap them, beloved. Clap them, clap them. I know you all has been waiting for a while, but that clap suggests to me that you want to clap, but you don't want to clap. I'm going to ask you now to clap. Very good, and thank you. My name is Ludlow Lawrence. I am God's servant for many years. And so, I've met Sheron a few years ago, and few could be said, you know, maybe 10 years or thereabout. And I've met Kenneth almost over a year ago, right? And they both have a commitment to each other. And most importantly, they have a commitment to God. And they are depending on you and me and everybody else to support them in keeping this commitment. And so, brothers and sisters, you may be seated at this time while they stand. We gather here today in the presence of Almighty God with one another to join this man and this woman in marriage, which is an honorable relationship. It is ordained by God and the very nature of his being, and designed to bring about comfort and happiness. Brothers and sisters, this holy relationship is not to be entered in unadvisable. And that's why Kenneth and Sheron did over 4 hours of premarital counseling. Because the devil is rampant when it comes to marriage. The devil is also rampant in destroying lives. But we come against all of those plans in Jesus' name. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hey, listen, we want to do what we're doing, but if you don't work with me, you might cause me to preach a little. And that's not my intent, right? But we're in church, and we're in church to honor God over this marriage. So, brothers and sisters, it is ordained through the scriptures that the wife will submit herself to the husband, and in a greater manner, the husband will love his wife. Yes, and so, without any further ado, I want to invite Reverend Robinson to open us in prayer. Reverend Robinson.
Let us pray. Almighty God and everlasting Father, we want to thank you for this opportunity of being here this evening. We ask, O Lord, that you knew this journey long before we even commenced it. And so this evening, Lord, as we come, you all have ordained this day. You have ordained these two lives. The journey that they have traveled on up until this moment, God, you knew it all. And so now, Lord, we ask for your blessings over their lives. We ask you, this God, that you will now speak into their life that which you have proclaimed long ago, and that truly there is, Lord, from here on, their lives will not be two separate lives anymore, but their lives will be one, joined according to your word. So we ask that your blessings will be upon them. We ask your blessing upon this evening. And we ask, O God, that your name will be glorified in all things. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Rev. And so we're going to be blessed by the reading of God's word. We should never have a Christian service without hearing the reading of the word. It's no wonder Jesus himself says, now we are clean through the word. And so at this time, I'm going to invite Reverend Violet Bailey to come and do the reading for us.
as Jesus continued the Beatitudes, he got to a place where he said, "You are the salt of the earth." So let me read for you St. Matthew chapter 5, reading from verse 13 to 16. "You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its savor, where should it be salted? It is henceforth good for nothing, put under the sole of men, be trodden. You are the light of the world. A city which is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." This is the word of God.
Thank you, Sister Bailey, for reading the word. The light of the world. And so that's what will shine in your life. It's not me who ordained it. It was ordained by God. And so we were told through the scripture, for this very same reason, Kenneth, shall a man leave his mom and his dad, cousins and sisters and brothers too, cleave to his own wife, because your both becomes one. Amen? And I know some people, them never have both. We have any American here? All right, so let me talk properly. We have some persons who do not know when not to say certain things. But they never have nothing good that can come from their mouth to say about others. Now, through the scripture, we were told that death and life is in the power of a tongue. And so I'm going to encourage you to encourage them and to hold them up and to make sure that their marriage is the best one in town.
Right.
Oh, you're not hearing me.
Amen.
Oh, I'm not getting an amen.
Amen.
I am a very responsive preacher, you know. If I say something and it makes sense, say amen.
That's right.
And if it hurts, just say, oh, shh. Are you feeling it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to help them to be the best couple prescribed through the scripture.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God.
Amen.
I feel Jesus here in Gateway.
Amen.
And if you're not feeling him, you're at the wrong place.
Amen.
Oh, bless the Lord. I need to be it myself, but I'm feeling very happy for you, Kenneth. I know where the journey starts.
That's right.
And thank God we make it thus far, and we have a far way to go.
Yes, sir.
It is until death. We believe in the scripture.
Yes.
That marriage is honorable. And young girls and young boys out there, don't let nobody tell you no tripe or foolishness. If you are good enough to be somebody's girlfriend, then you are better enough to be the wife.
Right.
Oh, somebody pushing you here this morning. Can I say that again?
Yes.
And then I'm going to behave myself, I promise you. If you are good enough to be somebody's boyfriend or girlfriend, then you're better enough to be the wife.
Amen.
And if you can't propose to you, it's time for you to pack up.
Kick him to the ground.
That's right.
Oh, you're not here, dear.
Kick him.
It's time for you to pack up.
Yes, sir.
Because marriage is honorable.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God.
Amen.
I really feel Jesus in this house.
Amen.
It's not time for me to preach. But listen, if you're not prepared to marry to you, tell him it's over.
It's over.
Because he doesn't belong to you.
Right.
And you're too much of a precious person to be fooled.
That's correct.
That's right.
Oh, are you hearing me?
Amen.
Oh, can I move here for a minute? Are you hearing me?
Amen. Yes.
Young ladies,
yes, sir.
Take control of your life.
Right.
Don't have anybody boxing you from pillar to post.
No.
You are more valuable than that.
That's right.
You are chosen. Oh, Lord. Let me go back over here.
Yes.
You're a chosen vessel.
Yes.
You're a royal priesthood.
Yes.
And so if you can't treat you like that, pack up. Go home back to your parents.
That's
Oh, you're not hearing me?
That's right.
Let me be it myself. I know after this nobody wants to hear me, but that's all right. Amen?
Amen.
God is blessing your wedding, brother.
Bless the Lord.
See, we have the nice rain here this evening.
Perfect.
Anything that comes from above is blessing.
Blessing, blessing.
Amen.
And so even if people don't want to bless you, I'm blessing you through God.
That's right.
And so, is there somebody that wants to give this beautiful young lady to Kenneth this evening? Who is that person? Well, that's your Pastor Bailey.
Yes, sir.
Pastor Bailey?
Yes, sir.
Make sure you visit them.
Amen.
Once per month for 1 year. Not just to give away, it's to watch over.
Watch over.
It's to encourage.
That's right.
It's to hold hands. It's to pray about things.
Yes, sir.
Amen?
Amen.
Because a family that prays together
stays together.
And these are things that the devil don't want to know.
Yes.
The devil don't want family to come together. The devil wants to redefine marriage.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Let me stay here because we might not finish this debate. We might not finish. But I would say this. Before I take the ring and bless it and ask you to give her the ring as a token of your love to her and vice versa, now let me tell you this. God is going to bless your union.
Amen.
And I want you to claim it.
Amen.
And I want you to believe it.
That's right.
And when things is happening, sometimes you don't know how to solve it, start to pray.
Amen.
For when you pray, then the Lord will have his way.
Yes.
And I don't care where the devil come from. It could come from the pit of hell. Prayer changes things.
Yes.
Hallelujah to the love of God. You know when Peter was in prison? You know what the church did?
Prayer.
Yes.
They called a prayer meeting.
Yes.
And even before they start to pray, God responded.
Amen.
They heard a knocking on the gate.
Yes.
Right.
And the scripture says, they made an inquiry. And then they said, Peter is on the gate. They said, cannot be.
No.
But that's a power of prayer.
Amen.
Power, power.
So Pastor Bailey, make sure. And I'm going to hold you to it.
Amen.
Visit them once a month. Pray with them. Give it our way. We're going to hold them together and pray with them. For 1 year. Any more thing don't think you can call. Alright? Good. Can I have this one?
Thank you, God bless.
Oh. Stay right here. Because before you put on the ring, the church need to know why is it that you put on the ring. So I want you to say after. Now if you don't say it, we're going to leave you here. You say it, then you will go with us. And more importantly, go with us. So say after me, Kenneth. I, Kenneth Wellington.
I, Kenneth Wellington.
Do take you. What's your name?
Sheron.
How are you?
Sheron Bailey.
Mm-hmm. To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To live together after God ordinances.
To live together after God
ordinances. In holy bond of marriage.
In holy bond of marriage.
I will promise you. In the presence of God and before these witnesses.
In the presence of God and before these witnesses.
To love you.
To love you.
To comfort you.
Comfort you.
To honor you.
To honor you.
Oh, that's a whole thing you say there, Kenneth. Well, let's say it again. To honor you.
To honor you.
Mm, say it again. To honor you.
To honor you.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. I feel Jesus in this house.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
In prosperity.
In prosperity.
And in adversity.
And in adversity.
Forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
Remain faithful to you.
Remain faithful to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I will.
I will.
That's a lot of promise there. It's a promise.
Amen.
Sheron, look in his eyes. By the way, Sheron, could you just untie your hands for a minute? Look around, Sheron. You look around. Is he the right one? All right, so hold back his hand. We want to make sure there's no guessing this business. This is the reality. Now, hold his hand. Look in his eyes, Sheron. I, Sheron Bailey.
Take you, Kenneth,
to be
my husband,
to live together, after God's ordinances,
in holy bond of marriage,
I will love you, and I will cherish you, I will honor you. And I will comfort you in sickness and in health. And I will forsake all others and remain faithful to you as long as we both shall live. I do. Bless God, that's a lot to do with him. Clap them. We all stay on the land. Now, further to that, now, Kenneth, I'm going to bless these two. And I'm going to give it to you, okay? I'm going to show the whole church the commitment of love and extending this ring to your finger. Let us pray. And the only time I don't want you to take pictures is when we are praying, and I should have said that from the beginning. Whenever we are praying, or whenever we are reading the word, just those 2 times. Other times, you can take your pictures. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, today we thank you for the gift of love. We thank you for the expression of love. We thank you, Lord, for agape love. We thank you, Lord, for brotherly love. We thank you, Lord, for love that is within union. And Lord, this afternoon, we thank you for Kenneth and Sheron. And Lord, as they pledge formally their love to each other, we pray, Almighty God, that, Lord, you would bind them together like chain that is so connected that cannot be broken. We pray, God, as they extend this ring to each other, that, Lord, it will demonstrate not only a token of your love, but the responsibility that comes in this relationship. Father, we pray for a blessing upon their union. Bless them as individual. Bless them as a couple. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
All right, get it. So Kenneth, I want to pull that from you. Camera, are you ready? You can take your picture here.
Yeah.
And then you're going to put it onto our finger. It's all right to be nervous, Kenneth. Okay. It's all right. It's all right. Who's your best man? Come on, brother, best man. So I do give.
You, Sheron.
This ring. As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
All right, take it down to the download. Everything about that. Good job. Better than a lot of us as men. Good job. I know some men when they hold it, they go like this. Good job, Kenneth. All right, so your turn, Sheron. Huh? Kenneth?
Kenneth?
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
No, you can break this ring. Good.
Clap them.
We reach to this special section of our service that we call the signing and also the lighting of the candle. And so before we do the signing, I'm going to invite Reverend Opal Williams.
Thank you.
All right, I'm back with you, so clap them again. Kenneth, I know you want to do something.
Yeah, for sure.
I remember my time almost 15 years or so ago. I really wanted to do something, but you still have to wait. Today, we have witnessed God's plan. It is God's plan for a man to take unto himself a woman and call her his wife. And so today, before you, the witness, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I pronounce Kenneth Wellington and Sheron, I don't know if she still will use the name Bailey, but Sheron Bailey Wellington to be husband and wife. So Kenneth, before now, she was your wife to be. As of right now, she's now your wife. Show us what you want to do. Can you tell us you want to do something? Show us what you want to do. For those whom the Lord God has joined together, let not a man put asunder. Brothers and sisters, they have been coming a far way, and they are going on their merry journey. If you don't have nothing good to say, let me use a biblical word, and then I'm going to use a Jamaican phrase. The biblical word is, let your communication be yea, yea, and nay, nay. In other words, keep them all close. That is the English version. The Jamaican version goes like this, keep up your mouth.
Amen.
I don't know why I'm dwelling on this, but
amen.
I'm warning you.
Well on it.
I'm warning you. Because marriage is an honorable institution.
Oh, yes.
Institute to family by God Himself.
That's right.
And so, if you're doing anything that will hurt it, you're not going to hurt them. You're hurting yourself. And you're sinning against God.
That's right.
Before I pronounce the benediction and the blessings over your lives one more time, I'm asking you, family members, friends, well-wishers, every time you see them, encourage them.
That's right.
Encourage them. Some of us find it difficult to give a compliment before we start to accuse people. Give them a compliment. I hope you should be clapping every time I say give them a compliment. There's something going wrong in this world today. We hit by COVID. We hit by White House problem. We hit by Congress problem.
Yes, sir.
They can't come together to make ordinary people get a few shilling to make ends meet. There's problems.
Problem.
And we have the answer in the Church of God. And that is, we got to pray. Pray that God give them wisdom. Pray that God bring them together. And pray that people vote right. And pray that people don't only have back time talk, but you go to the poll and you also vote. And vote right. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, what kind of preacher is this talking about politics in a way?
That's how it is.
But love one another, care for one another.
Yes.
And let me tell you something, if we love and care for one another, then we're going to destroy COVID.
Yes.
Well, you didn't say anything to that.
Amen.
God bless you. My prayers is upon you both. Today is not the only day I've prayed for you. I've been praying for you for months. And I've been praying for this moment. And God allows us to see it. And I'm telling you, if you continue to love one another, then there's greater things that the Lord is going to use your life to help other people to be better Christian, to be better lovers, to be better wife and husband. Clap them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, I'm going to ask the congregation to stand at this time. So, may the blessing of the Lord, our Heavenly Father, rest upon you both, granting unto you all spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. May God permit you to share together a long and an happy and useful life here, and he made worthy to inherit all the joys of the heavenly life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Lord go with you.
Hallelujah.
Until I seen your eyes, still I had to try. Yeah. Oh yes. Let me get my words right and then approach you. Woman, I'll treat you like a man is supposed to. You'll never have to cry. No. I know everyone can relate.
Alright, let's start for a change. We're gonna bless the meal. We have been eating and drinking. We just want to pause for the call. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for a great afternoon you have blessed us with. We thank you, Lord, for the occasion. We thank you, Lord, for your people. Most importantly, Lord, we thank you for this man and this woman who connect in such a special way today in honoring you, himself, and their family. And Father, as we have already participated in eating, we thank you, Lord, for the provision. And we pray, Almighty God, that, Lord, as we eat, we'll eat virtuous to our bodies. Bless the food, O God. Bless the cake. And bless each and every one that is going to be saying something. And each and every one of us that will be eating and talking and encourage one another. Father, we thank you for everything in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Hi.
Hi, good evening, everybody. I was given the task to toast the bride. I met Sheron about 9 years ago.
What?
It's been that long? You know what? If anybody remembers the sitcom Golden Girls, here's a classic Golden Girl called Sophia. And when she's about to start something, when she's about to start a story, she always starts with, picture this. So picture this. It's 4 a.m. in the morning. Time to push the milk cart down the hallway. Then you hear, Holy Spirit enlightens us. That's usually Sheron in the mornings. This is how she starts her morning. On the... My friend, I'm so proud to call you friend. I have come to know and love you. But give me the shirt off your back, kind of a friend. I oftentimes think of when we first met on the job. I was told by a co-worker, you know how to call co-worker, so I do take your side and tell you things about people. So I was told by a co-worker that she's not liked very much. I remember saying, of course not. She's principled, she's respectful, she demands and gives the best care for her patients. She is no nonsense, of course. She won't be liked. I didn't know you then, but I felt I knew you. If you are here, you are extremely special to her. She does not let any and everyone into her inner circle. And because you are here, you are family. When she loves you, she makes an occasion out of your occasion. She blesses you with her time, food, and love. She summons you over like the queen she is. And when her royal highness tells you come over, you go. No questions asked. Just so you know, and I'm sure you do, she doesn't give up her sleep time frivolously. When you do get there, it could be a 5-course breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Doesn't matter which meal. Always a spread, and always amazing, tasty, delicious food. Scintillating conversations, and always with the presence of God. You are treated royally. Thank you, Sheron. You have enriched my life. And I love you for it. God has given you this man. I know you prayed for him. When you first told me about Kenny, I knew you were hooked and you were serious. That this day would be in the making, now finally here. I wish you and your union God's tremendous blessings. I pray that your love gets stronger daily. I pray that you will have loads of years together. I am so happy you have found, in your words, a decent man.
Yay!
That's what
you
told me. Just repeating it.
In her words.
Yes. You have him to love and to grow old with. Congratulations. And... at last, your love has come along. Your lonely days are over.
That's true.
And life is like a song. Congratulations, my dear.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. They said loneliness kills it faster than diabetes and love. All right. We move on to the next. The next person to give a toast is to the groom. Mr. Ricky Bailey.
Bless the Lord. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, I'm excited. And I'm happy. I want to give a toast to the group. Kenneth. Wellington. I know him for over 20 years. We worked together. So I know this man very well. And for 20 years to know somebody, he can't fool me. You understand? And I introduced my aunt to him 5 years ago. He came here. They get connected together again. Which is when God has something done for you. If it's for you, it has to be for you. If it takes 40 years, it's going to be for you. But back to Mr. Wellington. He has a lot of quality that I really admire. And I know my aunt is going to be happy. He's a man of discipline. He's a man of love. I remember when we were in Jamaica, he just planted his field and bring all these fruits. Planted for everybody who want to take it. That's a man that loves to give. So my aunt, I know he's going to bless you with love. He's a man for justice. Ever stand up for justice. And the thing I love about him, he's not quick to ignorance. He always calm and always say to me, make things easy. And so, as you join union today with my aunt, and we're all here celebrating, and the next thing, you also put God first. And as long as God is in the business, no matter what storm rock the ship, it's going to be good because God is in the business. And you're looking so beautiful over there, man. You're excited. You look like 40 years of your years. I'm so happy for you. But as you move on to your new life, there's a lot of tests you're going to be. Because the devil do not like people like March. The devil do not like March. The devil is going to hit at you with a lot of things. But as I say, you put God first, and if you live according to the word of God, your marriage is going to run good. And you have a strong woman beside you also. So you don't need to worry about it. Just continue to be the man you are, and continue to do what you have to do, my brother. And in Jesus' name, amen.
Yay! Very good, sir. Yes. Put God first in everything, you know, and then we live on forever and forevermore. Even after death, we live on. Okay, the next person to give toast to the chief.
Pleasure is mine. To give a tribute to my brother Ken. First, I must say congratulations to you and your beautiful wife.
Yes!
Now, I would like to draw your attention, Mr. Wellington, to Ephesians 5, verses 25 and 28. And it reads thus, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for it. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife, loveth himself. Some instructions. Have eyes for your wife only. Never let Sheron cry except for joy. And I'll do Sheron. Amen. Except for joy. Love her unconditionally. Cherish her, and most importantly, reassure her daily of your undivided commitment to her. And continue to walk daily with the Lord. He is the best thing that ever happened. A personal relationship with God. Thanks to Sheron, you can say you found the Lord down on your knees. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Can I get a
praise the
Lord?
Praise the
Lord! Okay, okay,
sister, thank you very much.
Thank
you, princess. You are most welcome. Alright.
So
we're gonna have Miss Violet Bailey, gonna give the five ingredients of great marriage. Give her a clap, please. I wonder that they really didn't let you dead yet, did, so come on.
Thank you.
Can I pass the floor, Richard?
I haven't heard your name yet.
My name is Sheron
and Mifflin Weddington. Congratulations first.
Thank you.
And prayer works. So before I bake your cup of cake, before I talk about the ingredients, I want to remind you of one thing. That when you are at my wedding, our wedding, and my sister-in-law is here. So,
can we ask them to stop the noise out there?
It rained, remember? So when I went up today, I said, wow, Sharon, this is the best day. It's fine. The teacher is waiting for audience. Thank you very much. Five ingredients of all the adjectives for marriage: strong, energetic, purposeful, wonderful, all of those words. But let me tell you what they are before I say anything else. They're all C's. So the first one is consecration. You did that today. Before the Lord and before the great witness you have in that church. And when you consecrate yourself to the Lord, what happens is that from then on, you have a new relationship, because that cements you. That's going to be the glue that keeps your marriage when God is first. So the consecration doesn't stop today. It continues, because He will give you His strong shoulders and His loving arms, and you've got to work on that. Well, the next one is character. If you remember scriptures, you well know by now, talking about the character of Christ, the spirit in terms of meekness and humility and kindness and love. Character is something that money can't buy. And it doesn't matter what worldly positions you have. Without character, you're absolutely without the real deal. So I know you are both of great character, and that makes me feel really great. And as I watch the both of you there, Kenny, I have to warn you, Sheron is a baby. And the babies are hot. You understand me? You see, I have one Siberian, so I can tell you. They're warm people. So always have that I am married to a baby. And Kenny, there are many of them in here, so watch it. You can't even breathe hard in church. And I know you won't, or else a host would come after you. But guess what? They love you because you're so pretty. The next one is communication. And most marriages suffer from that. And it's not always a spoken word, but yet it is. People talk about, I know he loves me, or I know she loves me, because I can see it. I want to hear it, and I want to hear it every day. I love you is a three-letter word. You both need to practice. And you can't practice love and afterwards get mad. That's inconsistent. So when once you say I love you, then that covers everything else that could come. In commitment, what happens is that you commit to grow. You commit to love. You commit to understanding. And you commit your moments of every day that become special from today onwards. Then, there's another one. That's a big one. When you, those of you who are students in C6H1005, we do some mix-up, you know, what the chemists do in the labs. That one is called chemistry. Ooh. Now, chemistry attaches you to the me within. So the person in you gets attached because of chemistry. And chemistry is warm. Chemistry is everything. But that alone can't make it work. So, it has to be cherished. But both of you must cherish each other. Always, always, always keep falling in love with that person inside you called the me within. And so as you age and grow in love together, it won't matter as you get older and not Sharon, you know, slim anymore like I was, but I'm gonna get back there.
True?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And it's really easy. But let chemistry light you up every day. It's the electricity that keeps the love going.
Yes, it
is. And
yes,
growing.
Yes!
And so, when you bake your new cake, with all the ingredients I've given you, knowing that your foundation is in God's love, it's an honor and a pleasure. My sister, I don't say in-law in my family, no. My new sister, my new brother, and you'll soon be over for dinner.
Wonderful. Well done. Bless your heart. Well done.
Yeah, and yeah, for my interpretation of chemistry on a night like tonight, you know, the sheet has to be set to bed. What's up? You said the place of blaze?
No.
What did I say? Oh, okay. All right, let's move on. All right, we're gonna have the chief.
Auntie, that's not gonna work right now, man.
The toast to the chief. I just saw her there.
Oh,
are
chief right here.
Yes. What are you, shy?
I'm actually... Go ahead, let's do your thing, Angel. Okay. Can we go to my thing that I had here?
Hello.
Hi.
I am Angel. I am the angel of the family. Angel. Alright, so my aunt is in your hands now. Out of my hands. But you know what? I'm so happy she's happy. That's number one. And even when it gets hard, that sometimes it will.
They can't hear you up there.
I'm sorry. But, you know, sometimes it does get hard, and it's okay. Sometimes it get rough, and it's okay. As long as you guys know that you guys are one. You understand? You guys can just work through anything. So you have your home, you know, little circle. The only people that's in your circle is you and your husband. Everyone else, then it's your children. And then it's your sister, that's how it is. But you guys are a union. And because of you guys, he made everyone in this house family now. I want to wish you nothing but the best, long life, good health, and happiness. I love you so much, Auntie Sheron. I'm like the mini version of her. She's a brat. Know that. She's a brat. And she's a little dominant sometimes.
Well, she's
but she's loving. She's love hard. She's a bull because she's a Bailey. So we are tough. But she knows that she has to submit to her husband.
Strong woman, right?
That's right. And that's all. So thank you. I wish you guys nothing but the best.
Thank you.
Very good. Very good.
Can you find a song?
The who?
No, she's not talking about.
I'm going to take this phone right here.
All right, we're going to play this song for Mother.
Mother's
blessing. Oh
my God. Oh, yeah, I'm going to borrow mine. I've been in trouble if I give earlier. That's why I
think it's. That's deep, right?
Let me have some.
And
it.
Oh,
thank you. Back your lashes, Niger.
All right.
Because we don't think
you can't find them
right now.
While the world looks upon me as I struggle along, they say I have nothing, but they are so strong. In my heart, I am rejoicing. How I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me.
All right, we're gonna have another toast given by Sonia.
Sonia,
I am Sonia. Sonia, here
is
that?
Sonia,
oh.
This is Sonia.
Oh, it's
a... I am Sonia.
Okay, Sonia.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Good night.
My loving uncle, Kenneth, and my auntie, Sheron. Congratulations, you new life ahead. And I'm so, so happy for you. Uncle, you know I love you. And tonight you have a beautiful bride beside you. And I'm so, so happy. So, party. The bride and the groom. May I wish you health. May I wish you happiness. May I wish you wealth and everything else you could wish for. May your love always be added and be never be subtracted. May your whole soul multiply and may your heart never be divided. Love you, Uncle. Love you, Sheron. Thanks for having me now in our family. You are my new aunt, and I love you. And Uncle, please take care of Sheron. And Sheron, please take care of my uncle. Love you guys. Have a blessed night, and congratulations.
Thank you, Sister Sonia. Okay, we're gonna have the bride and dance now.
Woo!
We're gonna see Dr. Wellington skank on the floor.
I'm sure, are you ready to work on these?
Take care of my brother, and my brother, please take care of your wife. Okay? But may God bless you and keep you and for long life.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sister. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh!
One bit with that. Yes,
what is that? Come on, Dr. Wellington, see you in our scan.
Oh, Tonight. sweat. Hard work, that. Hard work. Yeah, man. What do you say, me, Wola?
Everything between us is good. I'm riding this cloud, baby, ready to fly, but before I take another step, would you catch me if I fall for you? 'Cause I'm falling, I'm falling. I'm so used to standing, so used to being on my own. But this thing is new, babe. It feels like I'm losing control. I'll take another step. Catch me when I fall for you, 'cause I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling. Will you promise to be there? Stay by my side always, whenever I need you. Don't let me down. Do that for me, hold me. Will you love? Will you love me? I'm gonna go.
with a pole.